Okay, welcome to Minneapolis High School Basketball here on 910KND.com as well as Eagle Communication Channel 8 in Minneapolis as Minneapolis Lady Lions getting ready to take on the Ellsworth Lady Bearcats tonight here on the home floor. And Mike, it's great to be back at home in the friendly confines of Minneapolis High School.
Well, we've been on the road for about two or three weeks solid here. Minneapolis getting ready to take on the Lady Bearcats from Ellsworth. Here on the home court, as Scott mentioned, I kind of look forward to this game since you and I both missed over at Ellsworth. We had just had some things going on. I can't even remember what we were doing.
Well, I know that I was afraid of leaving town with my wife being...
I know you had an excuse, but I was trying to think of what mine was at the time. But Lady Bearcats, pretty tough team usually for Minneapolis to play against. And... as I look down the starting lineup, there are a couple that I remember from last year. They have a Shoemaker all their own, and she's a senior. Cassie Landon, a sophomore, will start. But they start Cranston, McCoy, and Connolly, and they have Aurora. And Swatty. It's S-V-A-T-Y, but it's Swatty.
Swatty, well, that's there's some Swatty. We have, I believe, a state representative that's a Swatty.
Yes, they are related.
They are related. So
those referees are giving the instructions to the players. They're just talking with the Lady Bearcats. Minneapolis captains are not there yet. But kind of look for Minneapolis to have the way here tonight, but I'm just...
Yeah, and Dale, I didn't even see how the first time we played Ellsworth at Ellsworth, how'd the ladies do?
The ladies won 53-30.
53-30.
Mm-hmm. So 20-point win. I kind of look, you know, as much as this team's improved over the last, I'd say two, 3 weeks, you know, it seems like they improved just immensely, and then they'll have a game where they can hardly put the ball in the rack and they kind of forget what they're doing on defense and score 37 points, but and then next game they go out and score 60. So that I think they're a little bit up and down.
That pair of guards, Zaveski and Steineke, that did fairly good. Trying to remember who else might have been of note. Those are the main two, I believe.
You know, we lost a close one at Clifton Clyde. Came around and only scored 38 points in that game. Then turned around at Russell. Now, granted, Clifton Clyde was a pretty solid team, but turned around and played at Russell and scored 56 points. So it almost seems like if we score some points, we've got a pretty good chance that we're going to come with the victory.
Yeah, we're off and running. With the only exception is we put 58 points on the board against Sacred Heart and still got clipped. But
I didn't say it's foolproof.
But I have to agree with you, Scott, there when Minneapolis is making their outside shots and scoring, making the other team turn the ball over in the front court and getting easy shots, easy layups. They do. They get on a roll, and they're hard to stop.
Yeah, Ellsworth had a lot of trouble with the press when we were at Ellsworth.
And how much of a difference does it make to finally be at home?
Well, I hope it'll make a lot of difference, and I hope there's a lot of fans here tonight to welcome them home.
Yeah, and so far it looks like a pretty good crowd. Now, this is a makeup game, so a lot of folks don't remember that this was one that was canceled early on, and it's a makeup game. But so far, it looks like a pretty good crowd, and the band's already playing, and looks like they're excited to be at home as well.
I was just curious what our record is. Did he put that on one of these?
Our record currently is 6-7 overall, and 3-3 in the league. Ellsworth is 0-13, and 0-6 in the league. So it's not been a good season for the Lady Bearcats.
So you would assume that Lady Lions should be able to do their thing here tonight, and boy, wouldn't it be nice to get to 500 with the record.
Oh, yeah, it would be. Yeah, it absolutely would be. But on the flip side of this, what has Ellsworth Bearcats got to lose?
Yes.
They're going to come into this thing and say, hey, we haven't won a game yet. What a big momentum booster that would be to come in and knock off a team on their home floor. So I'm sure Coach Weatherman has addressed that, and I'm sure that he's talked with the girls about coming out and getting lights out and on fire and pushing the momentum. I think you're right, though. I like our chances with the press. I think our press Well, it's created turnovers in the past, and if they have not adjusted from the first time we played them, Dale, it may be, it could be a big benefit for us.
I know our guest announcer, Mike Farmer from KINA, was just flabbergasted at how Ellsworth could not handle our press. So it was quite impressive that night.
So we're about 4 minutes and 19 seconds away from the start of this ball game, as the Lady Lions with their home white. Boy, we haven't said that all in a long time, have we, Mike?
You know, even the midseason tournament down at Hoisington, we were the visitors just because of the seed arrangement in the bracketry. But, gosh, we were dressed in road reds all tournament long, and I don't think we got into our fights at all down there, maybe once, but... Anyway, the girls, I know they're looking forward to playing at home, and they play real well on this floor. That 2-2-1 zone trap, I think it's more effective on, seems like, the friendly confines here.
Yeah,
that way.
I think Jay Macy said an interesting statement at the beginning of a while ago. He said, I wonder how many other high schools in the nation can say it's February 2nd, and we're playing our second game at home for the season.
Yeah, but you know what an opportunity we have because of the fact that we are 6-7 and we're at home for the pretty much the rest of the month of February, with the exception of traveling to Republic County, Dale.
Yep.
And that's that is a huge benefit for the ladies.
Yep. Yep.
So
what's our league record, Dale? Do you have that offhand?
The girls are 3-3.
3-3. So we are 500 in the league. This would put us 4-3. It's big. This is a big game.
Yeah, it is. It is. It does. It's a big game. It also, every game's big leading up to sub-state seeding. But you're right. It is a big game, and it'll be exciting to be at home here and have a chance to come away with a victory tonight.
A couple other interesting facts. This is the 68th game in the series. Ellsworth leads it 37-30, but MHS has won the last three games. And again, on the 9th of January at Ellsworth, we beat them by 23. Another interesting note here, we've been talking about Shea Shoemaker and scoring, et cetera. In the last game, she moved into 9th place in all-time scoring at MHS, moving Mallory Goeth back to 10th. She now has 650 points. She needs 18 points tonight to move past her sister, JC, into 8th place.
Well, I look for that to happen tonight for sure, Dale.
Yeah.
She's moving right up the scoring ladder there.
Watch out.
And still has another year to go.
Yep. The record is 1,447 career points, guessed by you-know-who.
Shoop.
Yeah, Christy Shoop.
Christy Shoop. Dale was just mentioning Shea Shoemaker needs 18 tonight to move in front of her sister, JC, on the all-time scoring. JC.
No, JC.
JC, really? Really?
I got a ways to go to get
there. JC's in 8th right now.
In 8th. Oh, 18 points tonight, huh? So where's Jarrett missed out at then?
Jarrett is second, I believe.
Okay.
Second or third.
Okay.
Wow.
So yeah, Minneapolis gets rolling on that press, and right the center of the court, Shoemaker's always there close to the ball. She could score a bunch. She put 29 on the board the other night. I thought she only had 19 or 20, so she can score in a hurry. We're getting ready for the starting lineups here. Minneapolis taking off their warm-ups. We have Amber Buckles back. She, I think, went on a little vacation with my niece.
Well, we worried about that.
After the fact. But I'm glad she got a chance to go skiing.
I wonder how much that will affect her for playing time tonight.
Well, the gimpy knee, evidently it's strong enough to go, so that's good. Minneapolis here getting ready for the tip-off. We're a minute away. We're going to have a starting lineup here.
Yep. As the Minneapolis Lady Lions and the Ellsworth Lady Bearcats getting ready to do battle tonight. And you're looking down, Ellsworth's got some size, Mike. You know, they've got some players that look like they're fairly good size.
A lot of 5'7 girls on that team. And they have some senior leadership. They've got a couple seniors. And as I mentioned, one's a Shoemaker.
And it looks like we're going to have the national anthem, and this is kind of exciting. It's going to be performed by our choir. And, you know,
at least the ladies.
Yeah, and our, you know, our assistant coach for the ladies, Sarah Bland, has done a tremendous job with the vocal music department. We're going to go ahead and have the national anthem. So we will let you listen with us. You're listening to 910KINA.com as well as Eden Communication Channel 8.
By the Minneapolis Concert Choir under the direction of Ms. Sarah Bland. Please remember in your thoughts our servicemen and women who are protecting our freedoms both home and abroad.
Sounded good, Mike. Nice job by the ladies out there as they did a great job with the national anthem. Pretty exciting to see. Great number of girls out there performing, and they did a great job.
How about that rendition?
Sounds pretty good to me. So.
Really good. And the voice of the Minneapolis Live, we have Danny Forchler here with the home commentary. He will give us the lineup here. Number one, Heather McCoy, 5'4 senior, introduced first here for Ellsworth, and for Minneapolis, Tyson Macy. Her counterpart on the floor. I like the matchup there. And for the Lady Bearcats, number three, we have a 5'6'7 junior, Brittany Murrow. As Scott mentioned, they do have some height. Murrow, a 5'7 junior. And her opposition tonight will be Kylie Gregg, the swing guard for Minneapolis. 5'6", sophomore.
You know, just as we're looking, I just saw Charlie Lynn walk in.
Yes, he played in the booth. He played in the junior varsity.
Mackenzie Cranston, a 5'10 junior, will work at the post for the Lady Bearcats. Cassie Landon, a 5'4 sophomore for Minneapolis, Kay Shoemaker, and J.C. Krausen gets the nod here tonight in the starting lineup for the Lady Lions. Lady Bearcats will start a 5'8 sophomore, number 20, Madison Connolly. So they do have some up front height between 5'10 and 5'11.
They do, but you know, basically they do start two sophomores, two juniors and a senior. But you know, most teams come in, and granted they've already played us once, but I don't think very many teams are going to put as many young players on the floor as we do. And we've talked about that all year. And that, I think, has got to be, getting to be a growing advantage for us because of the fact that these girls are maturing each and every game.
I was talking to the Ellsworth girls up here filming, and they didn't know exactly who was starting because, well, they switch up quite often, so they do. They probably go 8-9 deep in their bench, and as Swati and Bettenbrock both will, and Steineke will be the three that I think will see a lot of time, along with this starting five right here. Shea Shoemaker getting ready to jump center against Landon. excuse me, that's Cranston. Will jump center for the Lady Bearcats. Minneapolis playing for the tip here, and we get it off J.C. Crossan. Left-hand dribble off Shoemaker, back out front to Page. Shot from the left-hand wing, no good. Shoemaker with the stick back, offensive board.
Nice offensive rebound by Shoemaker there, and she did a great job. And right there's a turnover.
Nice feed by Shoemaker, catches Eichel Macy on the left-hand side, streaking into the basket. And it's 4-0 all of a sudden. There's another turnover. Macy on top of that ball from Minneapolis, gets it off to Drag. Oh, my. Drag.
Well,
to
okay.
Take off and stop.
Kylie didn't have a turnover there. Kylie didn't have the turnover there, but I think Ashlyn did when she rolled over on the floor.
Yeah, they didn't call it, so Kylie had it.
Yeah. So, see if that's any better, Mike.
Thank you. 2-3-1, or 2-3 zone defense here by Minneapolis. Ellsworth with the ball on the wing, trying to find a spot. There's quick hands of J.C. Crossan in the turnover as Minneapolis is on the move again. Crossan with the ball on the left-hand wing. Now Shoemaker on the baseline, back out front to Macy. We reset the offense, and it's a man-to-man defense for Ellsworth. Now three-point shot, Page over the rim, no good. Shoemaker had a hand on it, but it goes out of bounds to Ellsworth. Well, so far the pressure defense has created two turnovers on the press and one just in the forecourt. Now Page with the quick hands and the good defense.
Swings back on the outside.
Not much going on here. There's no movement on end. They throw it away.
And that is, I am keeping track of turnovers, at least for Ellsworth tonight, as that is their fourth turnover right there, as Lady Lions will have the ball.
I need to get my number circled in the other box so I can spot them. Shoemaker on the baseline, back out front. Now the entry pass to Crossan, back to Page, in she goes for the layup. I think if she would have used her left hand there, it would have had a better chance of going in. It was blocked, and she will get a two-shot foul here. First foul on Brittany Merle. Page here with two shots. First throw on its way. Good. Nice rainbow arching shot. Nothing but net. And you know, sometimes, Scott, just a good free throw make gets them on a roll shooting from the outside on the floor. That one's running off.
Yeah,
well,
and
could be
off of J.C. Crossan, they say. But, you know, that's a good point. And she's kind of had a couple rough nights shooting-wise. And
I think she's kind of a streaky shooter. If you get her going in that way, I think maybe that'll help her out in the long run. There's a good defensive stop by Page in the tie-up. Possession arrow to Ellsworth as Landon gets caught in no man's land.
Brittany Bettenbrock checking in for the Bearcats.
Bettenbrock in. Shot from the baseline, no good, and Macy clears the board for Minneapolis. Nice open look by Madison Connolly, but she can't get it to drop. Out front, Gregg saves it.
Oh,
nice job, Kylie Gregg.
Nice job by Kylie. Kylie looked at the floor, saw her feet, and still got the ball saved in Ashlyn Macy's hand. Nice job by Kylie Gregg, presence of mind to watch the floor and not go over and back.
Nice acrobatic work there.
Yeah. Did the tightrope at half court, and they dividends there. Minneapolis playing it in. Macy over to Shoemaker, three-point shot on its way, rimming off. Boy, Crossan is there to get a hand on it. The follow shot by Page is no good. Look at Crossan run the floor. That's
there's travel. Nice job by Crossan running the floor.
For a foul girl, she just flat gets up and down the floor, doesn't she?
She does. Nice job by the Lady Lions. Jalene Shoemaker, a 5'5" senior, checks in for the Bearcats. As you said,
there'd be no relation. Drag on the wing, back out front to Macy. Now on the left wing, shot by Page is just rimming off. It looks good from here. Now we have a reach-in foul on Drag. I believe it is on Kylie. Yes,
that is her first personal foul, first team foul for the Lady Lions.
5:29 left, first quarter. Minneapolis 5, Ellsworth nothing.
Oh, well,
oh,
Macy.
Great try there by Macy.
And Thompson almost with the steal. Now underneath, Shoemaker gets a hand on that one as Connolly looks for someone to throw to. Now dribble drive by Ellsworth, hands it off to Shoemaker. Her shot's no good, and Page.
There should be a foul on number three as she reached over the back. As foul will go on Brittany Murrell.
You know, Murrell had the easy shot. She handed it off to Shoemaker, and I think she was too under the bucket, yeah, too far under the bucket to get the shot off.
Second personal foul by Murrell.
Two team fouls for Brittany.
Page to play it in for Minneapolis. Macy clears the timeline for Minneapolis. 2-3 zone now for Ellsworth. Now the dribble drive by Gregg. Baseline jump shot, no good. Shoemaker gets a hand on it, and Page hustles it out to get that long carom. Now Gregg takes over behind the back dribble. And the foul is called on Bettenbrock.
That'll be her first. That's her first foul.
And that's Lady Bearcats' fourth team foul. Minneapolis will play it in. At the 10-second line, now Macy looks at a three, passes it up, crossing on the baseline, back out front to Macy. Now Macy on the left-hand wing, dribble drive into the paint, pass almost over the head of Gregg, it is, and Ellsworth claims the loose ball as Bettenbrock comes up court with it, crossing runs into her from behind. That'll be Jacy's first foul. Second team foul for Minneapolis. Conley to play it in over to Shoemaker. Back over to Bettenbrock. Back out front to Shoemaker. On the wing now, Cranston. They're looking for a cutter against this 2-3 zone, and there's no movement per se. Shoemaker is open for a minute in the paint. Now Cranston down the lane, dishes it, tries to dish it off, has it taken away by Shoemaker. And the bounce pass to Gregg. Jump stop in the paint, shot no good, and there's three Minneapolis girls to rebound that. Macy came out of there with it.
There's a turnover right there, a pretty simple one.
Shoemaker is fouled.
Nice job by Minneapolis right there. That turnover was just a bounce off of her foot.
Yeah.
And right in the hands of Shoemaker.
Shoemaker made a nice cross-court pass across, and the defense come together, and the return pass to Shoemaker was right on the money. She went up, she was fouled. Maybe a little too far under the back bucket, but I've seen her hit those before. Free throw is good. Shea Shoemaker as Steinbrock and Baker head into the game for Minneapolis for the first time tonight. 3:59 left. First quarter, 6-0. Minneapolis so far, no points for Ellsworth.
Ladies on top here. Second free throw's up, and it is good as well.
Boy, Shoemaker's just been solid at that free
she
throw.
Has been, she has been a tremendous job. Just a wonderful job.
Good job breaking the pressure. Almost a bad pass. Cranston claims gets underneath it. Now Shoemaker in there.
Nice block there by Shoemaker.
Steinbrock picks up the loose ball for Minneapolis. Shea with a nice block shot. Now Gregg on the right-hand wing. Gets it back out front to Macy. Good pressure by Ellsworth. Baker has trouble with it. Now Gregg on the right-hand wing. And she's got happy feet. Second traveling call on Gregg tonight, so she's going to have to watch her pivot foot there, as evidently the ref's watching that fairly close. Now Shoemaker gets it off to Bettenbrock on the right-hand wing in the lane. She loses control of it as McCoy had the pass go through her hands and off her forehead. And Minneapolis right there to collect that loose ball. Gregg off to Steinbrock in the corner, back up front. Baker, now Gregg on the left-hand wing, shot no good. And Steinbrock gets a hand on that, but it goes out of bounds.
We're having a hard time hitting anything tonight.
Yeah, we've not. We've had some nice-looking shots, but we just have not been able to hit them. Ellsworth takes a 30-second timeout. We will go ahead and take one with them, Dale, as the Lady Lions right now on top, 7-0 here with 3:02.
Since 1876, State Bank has been your trusted hometown bank. For over 100 years, they've been interested in helping people achieve their financial goals. Let them help you. The Bennington State Bank. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
City Pharmacy has brought you quality professional pharmaceuticals since 1963. Joe and Amber Wool will help you with your medications, durable medical equipment, cosmetics, gifts, and greeting cards. Your hometown pharmacy, City Pharmacy, downtown Minneapolis.
You know, Scott, I was kind of hinting towards the game later on. You know, Minneapolis just barely got clipped over to Ellsworth. The boys, 53-50 over there. I was listening to it on the radio. I've been kind of excited about this boys game later on today. I think the girls are going to have their way here this evening against the Lady Bearcats, but there's a nice job
break
by
on the press. Oh, great job by Ali Steinbrock to block that from behind. Great job by Steinbrock.
Now Greg on the right-hand wing looks inside. Shoemaker, turnaround, jump shot in the lane. It's good. Kay Shoemaker, about a six-foot turnaround jump shot in the paint.
Has anybody scored besides Shea yet?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's amazing. Turnover, and Steinbrock collects the loose ball. Now Greg on the baseline. Pulls it back out.
He about drugged that pivot foot.
Now Macy resets the offense. Baker on the left-hand wing, looking inside to Steinbrock. She's there. She kicks it back out to Baker. Baker's got Shoemaker if she wants her. Shea wide open. Long shot by Macy, rimming off. And Shoemaker with the rebound, but the reach-in foul is on Steinbrock, I believe.
Yeah, I believe so. Yep, Steinbrock with the foul.
Valley's first personal foul, Minneapolis' third team foul.
Allie had a great block down on the other side.
Wonderful block.
Down low.
9-0 Minneapolis, and Ellsworth will play it in. Chloe Shoemaker, Cranston, and Merle, and she's bumped by Steinbrock. That's her second foul, I believe, in about as many minutes. 2:02 left first quarter, and Steinbrock as her third personal foul. Paige will come back into the game for Minneapolis as Greg will get a break.
You know, the Bearcats have done a fairly decent job of breaking the press.
Yes. Yeah, they've made some first two turnovers, and then ever since then, they've done a good job passing the ball. Cranston back out front. Now Shoemaker shot rimming off. Nice job with the bank shot. She used the glass rather well there on that shot. Page to Macy on the right-hand wing. Page skip pass to Baker. Jump shot, no good. We had a hand on that rebound, but Ellsworth was able to bring it out of there as Bettenbrock. And there's another turnover. McCoy tries to save that one, but it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, nice nice effort there by a great skip pass by Kelsey Page to Baker. She just couldn't quite finish it, but it was a great pass.
There's another one just like it. Baker had the baseline if she wanted it. She'll get it next time. Now the entry pass to Shoemaker. Down the lane she goes. Shot no good. And Cranston has the rebound. Now the long pass down court. And they do a pretty good job running the floor as Conley comes down and hits the 6-foot jumper for Ellsworth. And they're on the board, 9-2, Minneapolis. Minute left, first quarter. Baker out front. Now gets the ball out front to Macy. Down the lane she goes.
Nice pass.
Kiss it. Left hand.
No foul.
Oh, she had the step back. Then she stole it. Tips it out there, and Macy gathers it in at half court. Now Shoemaker back out front to Macy. 30 to shoot. Shoemaker on the left-hand wing. And she cannot get her shot off against Conley.
They blocked the three-point shot for sure.
Page with a long three-point shot off the back of the rim. Now that goes out of bounds. Two Ellsworth, excuse me. Kind of a quick shot there, 20 seconds left in the quarter. I think Coach Weatherman would probably like to see us work it just a little bit longer for an open look. Now Ellsworth trying to get it across court and does. Cranston on the backside.
Oh, wow, nice block by Shoemaker.
And they hit the ball. Tommings the call as Page with the crossover dribble at three-quarter court and evidently is called with the palm.
Wow.
9-2.
Good hustle by Kelsey there.
Minneapolis, I was really surprised Shea Shoemaker didn't get a foul called on her. Now, long shot by Conley, no good. And that's the way the first quarter will end. That was close to going in as Conley lets it rip from 28 foot. It just hit the rim and rimmed off. Minneapolis leading here against the Lady Bearcats, 9-2. We'll be back with the second quarter here in just a minute.
The Hair Stylum, the newest and most modern hair salon in Minneapolis, will style your hair to give you the look that you've always dreamed of. Or you might just want a haircut. The Hair Stylum will do that too. Lynn and Brandon welcome new customers. Call 392-4555.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lionbackers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lion games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of Minneapolis Junior and Senior High School. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
Welcome back to Minneapolis. Wow, it's nice to say that. Welcome back to Minneapolis.
Yes.
As the Lady Lions at the end of the first quarter on top 9-2 over the Ellsworth Bearcats. And a good first quarter, Mike, but we missed quite a few open shots.
We missed probably three or four little six-foot jumpers, a couple on the baseline, 1 point blank out in front, but they'll start falling. Once they do, it's going to be Katie bar the door, because I think Minneapolis is going to put up a lot of points here. They scored a lot early, and then in the later portion of the first quarter, kind of slacked off, but I think Ellsworth changed their defense to a zone, so we're going to have to start hitting from the outside. Drag back in, crossing with a dump down pass to Shoemaker's, tipped away. Drag back out front to Macy. Now Page with the shot, goes up and in. Good deal. Kelsey Page with a shot from the elbow, about a 14-footer. And it's in. And we hadn't had a bucket for quite a while. There, Macy steps in front of that pass. Shot's up and in. And one. And we're going to count that bucket as Macy steps right in that passing lane, Scott, and in for the layup. And now all of a sudden, Minneapolis for an 11-point lead.
Yeah, nice job by Ashlyn there to step right in that passing lane. And she has a shot at putting the 3 points on the board right here.
Free throw is up and rimming off. No good. And Conley clears the board. She and Macy almost steals the ball. And she does. This time, crossing, the two of them are stealing at the same time as Landon comes down and gets her pocket picked. Now Paige travels as she has that extra step as she puts the ball on the floor, and traveling is the call.
Ellsworth's leading in the turnover category, 12-4 right now.
But well, scores already.
Scoring-wise, 13-2, Lady Lions on top.
Conley on the wing now. Bettenbrock looking underneath. Cranston was there. The ball was tipped out of there by Gregg. And Macy picks up the loose ball for Minneapolis. Now in the left-hand wing, Page, jump shot, good. Kelsey Page has hit her last two shots, which is good to hear.
Yeah. And I think for Kelsey, the key, if we can get some inside, that's a foul on Shea. If Kelsey warms up on the inside, dropping those 10-footers, the 6-footer in that case, she's going to start hitting some from the outside as well. And
wow. Kelsey's averaging right at 10 points a ball game, but Scott and I have mentioned as of late has not been shooting the ball well, scoring about 6 or 7 points, but we need to get her, you know, 12, 13 points a ball game. Out front, Ellsworth working against this 2-3 zone of Minneapolis. Not having much luck so far, and they don't look like they have much for an outside shooter, Scott. Now the baseline. Tipped out there by Page. As Conley gets it back out front to Landon, back to Conley. Entry pass to
another turnover.
Number 30 is a new, that's choice in the ball game for Ellsworth. Now dribble drive by Page, shot up, no good. And Gregg catches the elbow from Cranston and Macy with the reach in foul. And that will be Minneapolis' sixth team foul.
Kelsey Page had a great crossover dribble in there, and she is just going to improve so much as she continues. But that was a beautiful crossover, but she didn't use the glass.
It's just the point I was going to make. We should use the backboard.
Use the glass just a little bit, and that would have bounced right in. But that's easy for you and I to say from up here, and a lot tougher when you're down there on the floor. So
Landon back to McCoy, Bettenbrock tries to clear the timeline and does off the choice. Now on the left wing, Ellsworth looking to penetrate.
Oh, great job by Kylie.
But McCoy picks up the loose ball, and they've got Greg across the arm. It'll be her second.
Yep, second personal foul.
Well, the girls are not bashful about fouling, and have shown that all year long, as Minneapolis, Greg and Shoemaker and Paige and Macy have all seemed to play in foul trouble all through the game. Greg's second personal foul, and no, that's Minneapolis' seventh. 1-1, and Crossen with the big board for Minneapolis. We're in the Ellsworth shooting in the 1-1 now.
So Shea looked at the three, didn't
spin
do
move.
It. Spin in the lane, nice job, Shea Shoemaker.
She has hit the last three spin moves like that. I've watched her. As long as she stops and takes a shot, if she continues on, it seems like they call the traveling. Now the reach hand by Paige, and wow.
Yeah,
Greg,
there we go.
Was there, but Choice takes
her
down, and that's going to be their seventh team foul, and we're in the 1-1
We're
now.
In the 1-1
Well, it's pretty fast paced. Minneapolis with 17 points here in the first half. Shoemaker will come back in for...
No, that's not Shoemaker. That's
not
that is
Shoemaker.
Number 13. That is Steineke.
Steineke.
Whitney Steineke. First one is missed by Kylie. And nearly a tie-up, and they're going to get a foul on Shea Shoemaker.
Well, I just cringe at the thought these girls getting fouls 80 foot from the basket, and there's no need for that foul, especially with the pressure defense we have. We're going to get the turnovers. They've got 12, 14 of them already. McCoy will go to the line. Minneapolis 17, Ellsworth 2.
Ooh,
McCoy's free throw
goodness.
Off the glass is good.
Folks, that was a one-handed bank shot.
She gave it a spin in the palm and just flung it up there one-handed.
Interesting form as she doesn't use the other hand, just uses the one hand, see?
One hand. Shot it good.
Made them both. So,
and that is a nice shot and release by McCoy. Now the full court pressure by Ellsworth, which is surprising. We break it off to Paige, 2-on-1. Off the Greg baseline, back to Paige in the paint. Shot is up, no good. It should be white ball, and is.
If I remember right, guys, at Ellsworth, that girl did the same thing on her first free throw attempt and missed badly, and their second attempt, she used both hands. So.
Paige to play it in, 2-3 zone here. Entry pass to Shoemaker. And they got her on the arm. She'll go to the free throw line for a 1-1.
.509 left to go here in the first half. Lady Lions on top, 17-4 right now.
Zaveski with the foul. Shoemaker at the free throw line. First throw on its way is good. I've been pretty consistent with that call for the last three or four games. Shoemaker shooting a pretty hot 85-90% from the free throw line. I didn't jinx her there as the second one's in also. Full court pressure by Minneapolis. 2-2-1 zone trap. Zaveski back to McCoy. Now baseline shot is rimming off. Paige has it for a minute but never had control of it. Almost.
Which is good. Level. Which is good she didn't.
Greg looks at the three, passes it up. Now the entry pass to Shoemaker, or Crossen. Shoemaker, nice ball movement here. I can't hardly keep up with him. And Connolly tips that one away. She's leading the fast break.
Great job, Kelsey Page, as Kelsey shows her speed coming from half court there and gets her at about the, I'm going to say about the 6 foot long, yeah. 6 foot area and just strips out of one way. Nice job.
Connolly leading the fast break for Ellsworth, and she gets her pocket picked by Page from behind. 2-3 zone here by Minneapolis. Get past to Connolly. Back out front is tipped. They recover. Shot is no good. Kind of a wild shot. That should be white ball.
Yep.
Landon with kind of a wild shot. It goes off the glass. No good. And as Ellsworth tried to regain possession, goes out of bounds. And it will be Minneapolis ball as Baker comes back in for Minneapolis along with Steinbrock. 18 fouls apiece here. 4:18 left. First half. Greg looks at a three or pass to Shoemaker in the corner. Shoemaker throws it off the opponent as she was leaning
she
out
was
of bounds.
Leaning out of bounds. She just wisely just took it off of her body and nice job.
19-14, Minneapolis with a 15-point lead. Page to play it in. Nobody to throw to. Gets it off to Gregg.
Shea is such a smart player. Does a great job. Shea for three.
Just off the front of the rim, no good. That almost was a double dribble. Now the fast break by Ellsworth. It's up and in by Zavisky. Nice pass from Shoemaker on the back side. No, that's 13. That's Steineke, excuse me. There's a reach-in foul on...
No, travel. Called a travel on Kelsey. Moved her feet. A
couple of those.
So
Greg's got a couple of those, and so does Paige. The happy feet before they put the ball on the floor. Now Ellsworth on the move, clears the timeline. Oh. Steineke gets her pocket picked, and Landon gets it off now. Conley back out front to Buttonbrock. No one touched it. It went out of bounds as the entry pass from Landon could not find McCoy, and it's Minneapolis ball.
They've only tried the full court press once on us, and we broke it so easily they backed away from
it. Pulled it right off.
Back to a zone.
It's kind of a matchup 2-3 zone as Zavisky comes out on the point to guard the ball. Baker on the left-hand wing, skip pass to Page. Jump stop in the lane has a partial block. And she gets it right back. Shoemaker has it off to Page. And
nice
she can
hustle.
Make up a lot of ground, can't she? As she rescues the ball in the corner. Now Baker on the wing, looking inside, back out front to Shoemaker. 2:55. And left in the first half here. Gregg out front running the point for Minneapolis. Now Baker on the left-hand wing. Shoemaker looks at a three. Skip pass to Page. Down the lane she goes. Shot is good.
Nice job, Kelsey Page.
Bucket of the night.
Right at the free throw line. Nice shot by Kelsey.
21-6, Minneapolis. Ellsworth passing the ball real well on this break. Steineke had a shot that rims off. Minneapolis with the rebound. Page under control gets it to Shoemaker. Back to Gregg. Looks at a three and lets it rip off the front of the rim. No good. As Zavisky kind of looks like she travels when she takes off with the ball. There's a long shot by Ellsworth, no good, and Steineke claims the board. Now off the Zavisky shot is no good. Baker over McCoy for that rebound for Minneapolis.
Oh, nice pass down to Kelsey Page from Kylie Gregg, and that was a great look by Kylie Gregg over the top, down low, and Kelsey finishes it. Nice job.
Kelsey with four buckets here in the first half. Looks a little winded. She wouldn't admit it. She's not coming out for nothing. Minute 35 left, first half. Entry pass to Steineke, back out to McCoy. Now Zavisky. Baseline drive by Landon. Gets it back to McCoy.
Oh, slotted out of the way by Shoemaker. And then ran down by Kylie Gregg.
Now Page, three-point shot. She feels it.
Great rebound by Steinbrock on the floor, though. Great still. He'll be shooting. A great job by Steinbrock with a great rebound there.
Great position. She had the rebound all the way. Cleared out just a little bit with the body, but that drew the foul from Ellsworth, and I think that is on Buttonbrock, I think. And
that is
a change out as Ellsworth brings in three subs.
Third personal foul by Zavisky, so
Crossan and Macy in for the line.
Steinbrock, free throw line, 1-1. Shot's good. 9 points here in the first half by the freshman. Oh, excuse me, that's Steinbrock.
That is a freshman.
They both have the black ponytail. Allie Steinbrock at the free throw line, excuse me. Second throw is good. She gets them both.
Well, one thing you can say is they're both freshmen. How's
yes.
That, so.
I was halfway right. Ellsworth breaks the pressure. Entry pass to Cranston. Shot no good. And Shoemaker rips away the board for Minneapolis. Now Macy on the left-hand wing back to Shoemaker. And Ashland resets the offense for Minneapolis. Skip pass to Shoemaker, left-hand wing. Dribble drive down the lane she goes. shot off the front of the rim, no good as she tries the finger roll. Now we got him trapped in the backcourt.
Get down by Ellsworth there, yes. Break that one.
Oh, long shot by Conley is good. It's a long two. And it goes in. Conley with a nice shot. That's the only long shot they've taken, hardly.
25 seconds left, 25-8. Lady Lions on top. Ashlyn Macy goes in, she'll get fouled, she'll go to the line. It is double bonus time with 18.8 seconds left.
10th team foul on Ellsworth. That's the second foul on Landon. Macy's at the free throw line. We'll shoot two here. 18.8 seconds left. Free throw is nothing but net. 26-8. And Minneapolis having their way here in the first half against the Lady Bearcats. Second throw on its way. It's good.
Great to get a turnover and a bucket right here. Wouldn't that be nice?
Oh, that would be sweet. They
nice
do break
there.
The pressure by Minneapolis. They get it out front. Cranston now out front to Landon. Back to Cranston. 2-3 zone by Minneapolis. Landon lets it rip. It's in and out. Two to shoot. Macy's going to have to let it rip. It does.
Nice job by Macy. Presence of mind to get it up, though. She had a great presence of mind right there. Shot it from right about half court. Didn't quite have enough oomph. They did touch the bottom of the net. Hey, great job by Ashlyn Mason.
You know, that's the same thought that was going through my mind. I wonder sometimes if the girls know, have the court presence to know how much time's left, and she knew exactly because she was about three-quarter court. She was looking to shoot.
Yeah, exactly. So nice job by the Lady Lions. Minneapolis Lady Lions on top, 27-8 here at the end of the first half. We're going to go ahead and take a quick break, and we will be back with some stats. You're listening to 910KNA.com as well as Eagle Communication Channel 8. Mike Perry, myself, Scott Osherman. And as the Lady Lions have the lead 27-8 at the end of the first half, and a good first half, the press helped the Lady Lions in there. They missed some easy shots, so this one could have been well out of reach with the Lady Lions right now on top by 19 with a great effort by the ladies.
Yeah. Well, I didn't. Go ahead, Dale.
If we were shooting better than, well, I'm going to estimate 30% or less, the score would be pretty ugly right now.
Yeah, it would be, because we really only have 9 field goals. So, for the ladies, Gray has done really good from the free throw line tonight, Minneapolis has, which has been a great benefit. And really nobody in serious foul travel, Connie Gregg with 2, Shea with 2, and Allie Steinbach with 2. To run down the scoring for the Lady Lions, leading the way, Shea Shoemaker with 10 points, followed by 9 by Kelsey Page. And Kelsey came out in the second quarter, guys, and she had had some nice steals, nice putbacks, and had a little runner in the lane. Nice job by Kelsey. Ends with 9 in the first half. 6 by Ashlyn Macy and 2 by Allie Steinbrock.
I think most of Kelsey's points were in the second quarter. She didn't score too much in the first quarter, but man, she had a really good second quarter.
1-for-2 from the free throw line in the first quarter, and then she had 4 field goals. And really, she has 4 field goals. Shea has 3, and Ashlyn has 2, and that's our field goals. So,
you know, I really think we need to get Kylie Gregg going on the opposite side. It's kind of a skip pass thing. That skip pass goes the opposite side, and I've seen Kylie hit that shot from the elbow. It doesn't have to be a 3, and she's got a good shot. I'd just like to see her get into the offense a little bit more than what she is. But for the most part, I think this game's over with. Minneapolis will put them away here pretty quick, and we'll see a lot of the reserves. I just hope Shea gets 19 points.
Yeah. For the Ellsworth Bearcats, Madison Connolly with 4 points, 2 by Alina Savinsky off the bench, and 2 by Heather McCoy, both free throws on the floor. But the Lady Lions really doing a great effort, and they have a nice lead at the half to prove it. So, ladies, about 4 minutes away from the start of the second half, we're once again going to send it back for a word from our sponsors. You're listening to 910KNE.com as well as Eagle Communication Channel 8. Welcome back to Minneapolis as the Lady Lions on top by a score of 27-8. As Minneapolis comes out, they will have to come out in the second half, and we'll see what they can do in the second half, Mike.
just a minute away from the second half. I think the possession arrow is to Ellsworth. They'll play it in here to start the second half. I haven't seen Swati on the floor yet. I've seen her warm up. She's hit a couple of long balls. So it must be a bad ankle maybe. So maybe they're down a player or two. She looks like she's running okay. And maybe she's just not playing this year.
She did play at Ellsworth, so I wouldn't be surprised to see her play here.
Minneapolis will start the second half as they start the first half. I imagine some of the reserves are going to get a lot of minutes here in the second half.
You'd expect it. And remember, you got to have so many quarters, or you can only play so many quarters, six quarters. And I was reminded the other day, you can only play 20 game nights. So coaches got to watch the game nights as well when they play in tournaments, C-team tournaments, JV tournaments. But Ellsworth will have the ball to start the second half.
Merle with the ball out at half court, being guarded by Page, man-to-man. Defense, Cranston gets the ball off. Now the back out front to Connolly. Connolly, the only player to hit a fairly decent long shot. Now McCoy, down the lane she goes. Back to Connolly, three-point shot on its way, it's good.
Wow.
So Connolly with a nice look there from beyond the arc, knocks down a three-pointer. And I might have spoke too soon, the reserves may not get to play a lot in the second half. They keep hitting shots like that.
And then a turnover just like that.
Bad pass. Page gets it right back. She steals the ball right back for Minneapolis. Greg out front to Page. Merle lost the ball for a minute, but Page stole it right back. Now Macy on the wing to Greg. And that pass is stolen away as Greg's thrown it away two times in a row down here. And Cranston with the walk and turnover to Minneapolis.
Thought Ashlyn might have gotten called for a foul there.
She's helped the process a little bit, hasn't she?
She has.
Quick hands, quick feet, Ashlyn Macy now on the left-hand wing, skip pass to Greg on the right. Entry pass to Shoemaker, looks on the wing. Page, jump shot, no good. And Connolly with the big rebound gets it off to Bettenbrock. Now back to Merle. On the wing, McCoy looking for Cranston. Cranston on the baseline. Gets it in to Connolly, and the shot is up and no good. But J.C. Crossan is whistled with her third foul, I believe.
Yep, second fouls I've got her for.
I hope it is. Just her second foul, good. Now everyone has two. Crossan's second foul, and Connolly will go to the free throw line to shoot two. First throw on its way. It's good. 27-12 as Ellsworth scores the first 4 points of the second half here. And now Minneapolis just with a 15-point lead. Second throw on its way, short. Shoemaker with the rebound. 6:26 left third quarter. Page left wing out front to Shoemaker. Three-point shot is ringing up.
That's a shooter's touch for a three-point range, and Shea gets it to fall.
Looks like you were 15? 13.
13. I see it twice, I think.
You know, I want to make a comment. We've seen it at Clinton Clyde, it started, and then on the road to Russell, and then back at home tonight, we've got a pretty good student section.
Yes.
It's nice to see. Nice to see the students coming out, and we've got a good crowd here tonight.
Cranston on the right-hand wing gets it out to McCoy. She's looking inside. There's no one there. Nobody there. Connolly breaks down now. Cranston goes to get the ball, and Gregg steals the ball from Cranston. Quick hands of Kylie Gregg. Shoemaker now on the left-hand wing. Page, dribble drive, shot off the glass, no good. She listened to us.
She did listen to us. Nice job by Ashlyn Macy with the tie-up.
And that was a good-looking bank shot. It was off just a little. Good-looking bank shot.
Lady Lions should have the ball after the ultimate possession here. 5:37, 30-12, Lady Lions on top.
Page to play it in as Coach Weatherman calls the play.
Oh, look at...
Shea was all alone for just a second. Now Gregg looking inside. Has the ball tipped by Connolly. Now the left-hand wing, Page, skip pass to Macy. Now Greg on the right-hand wing. Skip pass to Page, entry pass to Shoemaker. Now to Cross, that was a real nice pass by Shoemaker.
Nice job, nice block there by Connolly.
And that's a tie-up, possession arrow to Ellsworth as Shoemaker pulls it down for Ellsworth and Crossing at the same time. It was almost a walk there. Ellsworth not really comfortable playing against this pressure, full-court press, but they get an easy one as Bettenbrock finds herself all alone under the bucket. And 2 points for Bettenbrock. Now Greg in the corner. Back out to Shoemaker. Dribble drive. Page all along from the way. No good. Crossing stole that ball away. And I think it's Connolly with a reach-in foul.
So,
no. That foul's on Shoemaker.
No.
I believe that's her third. No, that's just her first foul.
No, let's call him number, number five.
You got too many Shoemakers
Shoemakers out there, so. Levi is going to call a timeout, and Levi Osherman is sitting right up here. Levi, how's the basketball game going so far?
Yeah,
pretty exciting to see the Lady Lions out there winning and doing a great job.
Yep.
So pretty exciting to see the girls out there doing a nice job. And right now, Minneapolis with a 30-14 lead, and it's pretty exciting that the girls have come out with a great first half and starting the second half, and pretty fun to watch them out there shooting the ball. So. My kids are up here with us tonight.
We have company.
Yeah, we do. Dale Leach, Mike Perry, myself, Scott Osherman, and three of my four kids.
Amazing. A male Osherman that doesn't have much to say.
Shoemaker shot no good. And Crossing
nice
tie-up.
Yeah, if I let the headset go on his head, I guarantee it would be different stories.
Paige, play it in for Minneapolis. Alternate possession, Minneapolis gets the ball. Out front it goes to Macy. Looks at a three. Now Greg has a three-point shot on its way off the front of the rim. No good. Good-looking shot by Kylie. Just hit the front of the rim. Now McCoy tight ropes at half court off to Connolly. Connolly with the ball above her head throws it away.
Out of way, yep. You know, the Minneapolis is just, it's almost like they're just a bucket or two away from just breaking this thing wide open. Still up by 16, nice lead, but they've kind of had a cold shooting night.
Yes, they have. They missed quite a few easy shots. Haven't really hit too many long shots. Now a
nice pass
we can hit.
Great pass by Kylie Gregg to Kelsey Page, and Kelsey did a great job of catching on the run and taking that one right to the hole.
Now McCoy gets her pocket picked by Kylie Gregg. Shoemaker, the layup. Oh, no good. She is fouled by McCoy, and she will have a two-shot foul, second team foul on Ellsworth, and Shoemaker will go to the free throw line here to shoot two. I was up at Concordia and watched a couple of wrestling duels, and I'm here to tell you we have some very quality wrestlers on this team this year, and I'm going to try and film them sometime or another. There's a nice tournament here in Minneapolis coming up, but
I was disappointed to see the results weren't in the Salina Journal Center.
I was pretty impressed. Penn kid just worked that Bloit kid over. I was so happy to see that. It was pretty cool. It's a free throw, no good.
That's an unusual miss for Shea. Rebound goes in the hands of the Bearcats.
Steineke has the rebound, gets it off to Bettenbrock. Now underneath, Schultz back in. Now, Cranston, nice pass passed, and it's intercepted by Crossan. The entry pass to Steineke is intercepted now. Bettenbrock steps in front of that pass and intercepts it. Now Page gets it right back. Oh! She had a
good hustle
rider
by
going out of
Page,
bounds.
Yeah. Nice job by Kelsey.
On top and rides Kelsey out of bounds, but Kelsey hits the floor after that loose ball. Kelsey with 11 or 13 points here in this ball game?
11 points.
Page goes out along with Crossan.
As Baker and Steinbrock check in.
You know, you kind of see a rotation starting here with Coach Weatherman with the girls as he's playing about seven girls right now. Cranston with the ball is tipped away by Macy. Back out front, shot is rimming off. And Steineke right there for the stick back. Nice rebound by Steineke. Now Greg, baseline drive is shut off by Bettenbrock. Three-point shot by Shoemaker, no good. And Bettenbrock has the rebound, and Kylie Greggs whistled with the blocking foul.
Pretty good forearm shiver there.
Forearm shiver.
On the offensive player.
Foul is charged to number five, Kylie Greggs.
Zaveski in and Landon out. Bettenbrock plays it in to Steineke. Church on the wings. Zaveski to Cranston is tipped away. Baker picks up the loose ball as long arms by Shea Shoemaker creates the turnover. Macy shot from the wing, rimming off.
Oh, nice job by Baker. They took it into the hands of Kylie Greggs.
Riley Baker kept it alive. Now Shoemaker has both hands on the ball. Possession arrow to Lady Bearcats. Minneapolis leading 35-16. 2:29 left. Third quarter. Conley back in for Ellsworth. Zaviski with the ball, long pass to Steineke, left-hand dribble, all the way in she goes, back to Conley. Now over to Bettenbrock, shot is off the glass, no good. Ooh, yeah, I thought that was a jump ball as Choice is tied up. 5'7 freshman, possession arrow to Minneapolis, here's that press.
Full court press again, we saw this about the same time frame in for one possession, and we broke it, and we break this one fairly easy.
Baker,
as well.
Nice.
Oh, nice hustle there by
Bettenbrock. Jumps in there and steals it right back. I was just getting ready to comment on the 1-2-1-1. I don't like that zone trap because the 1-1s in the back can't cover the whole court. You saw exactly that as Minneapolis made it all the way down easy. Baker, baseline, kicks it back out to Macy. Dribble drive, shot is up, no good. Steinbrock.
Oh, Steinbrock called with the push. And that is her third personal foul.
Steineke and Steinbrock fighting for that loose ball. It goes out of bounds. And it will be Minneapolis ball, or Ellsworth ball, excuse me. Bettenbrock to play it in to Zaveski.
There's a walk right there.
Up skipping a jump there.
Yeah, Minneapolis filling the passing lanes, and she just could not make the pass because Minneapolis was in the way, and turnover. And it's a full timeout. We'll take one, too. Minneapolis leading 35-16, 1:42 left, third quarter.
The Hair Stylum, the newest and most modern hair salon in Minneapolis, will style your hair to give you the look that you've always dreamed of. Or you might just want a haircut. The Hair Stylum will do that, too. Lynn and Brandon welcome new customers. Call 392-4555.
If you're searching for the right insurance to fit your needs, look no further. American Family Insurance has been providing security and peace of mind for more than 80 years because they want to protect what matters most. Call Scott Osherman in Minneapolis, your American Family Insurance agent.
Minneapolis is a dynamic and growing...
Well, what do you think of the Lady Lions tonight? Look like they're going to be able to put this one away?
Yeah, I guess...
That kind of looks like you're playing pretty tough defense, don't you think?
Yep.
Played well, we get another bucket here, we'll be up 20 and probably seal the deal, don't you think?
Yeah.
All right, we got some good help here. Nine. Shoemaker fouled underneath. And she'll go to the free throw line to shoot two here.
And Shea will go back to line. Shea will go back to line for two as she gets fouled underneath.
Shea at the free throw line has missed one or so, but not there. That one's perfect. 36-16, Minneapolis up by 20. Lady Bearcats still trying to get something going on offense.
16 points for Shea tonight.
Zaveski plays it in. Steineke, Choice off to Bettenbrock. Now Conley with pass on the wing to Zaveski. Skip pass to Bettenbrock. Shot is no good. And Greg
over the
corrals out long carom, but I think the foul's on Baker underneath on the push.
That was Riley's first foul.
Riley Baker, number
don't have the number right on the foul. Anyway, Steineke, choice turn.
Nice job, Ashlyn Macy, to reach in there and force the tie-up. It will stay with Ellsworth, but quick hands by Ashlyn Macy.
Cranston back in. Choice goes out. They'll play it in under their own bucket. Connolly, skip pass out front to Steineke. Steineke, dribble drive, stops. Back to Connolly, three-point shot, rimming off. And Cranston with the rebound, shot no good. And J.C. Crossan clears the board on the backside. Good backside defense by Crossan. And 50 seconds left in this third quarter. Baker on the wing, entry pass to Crossan. Off to Shoemaker, is tied up.
No tie-up, it'll stay with the Lady Lions this time.
Yes, alternate possession to Minneapolis.
37-16, 46 seconds left to go here in the third quarter.
What was the score at halftime, Scott?
27-8.
So we've put 10 on the board here in the third quarter. I think Ellsworth has scored quite a bit themselves. Entry pass, Shoemaker, turnaround shot is, oh! She's going to shoot two, and she can get the free throw line, can't she? She gets her share of free throws.
Well, this could tie and break the record, or not the
tie
record, but her sister's record.
She'll tie it with 18, right?
Uh-huh. 18 breaks it. That
18
ties
breaks it.
That
ties it, so she ties her sister's
ties
record.
For 8th place.
And that's not Jerry either. That's JC's scoring record. That one off the front of the rim, no good. Connolly collects the ball. And Baker, that's tough luck right there, Riley Baker. Ball was kind of loose. Connolly gained control of it. Baker had one arm in there and is supposed to get a reach-in foul.
Kelsey Page will check in for Riley.
38-16, 35 to shoot here. Steineke with the ball above her head. Back to Connolly. Good defense over on the other wing. And there's J.C. right there. And Paige, so quick, up and down the floor, comes from behind to pick their pocket again. And she has done that three or four times here tonight. Crossan with the good defense. Starts it. Now Paige fell down. Crossan was on the floor. They have numbers. Shoemaker tips it away from Cranston. Baseline drive.
Locked. Good to get her on the arm.
Zavesky.
J.C. may be called with a foul. 3 seconds to go in the quarter. Oh. Called on Kelsey Page instead.
Zavesky, she's not afraid to drive the baseline. She must only be 5'3 or so.
We get her listed at 5'2.
Free throw on its way. It is good. Two-shot foul here for Zavesky. That's the sixth team foul on Minneapolis. Next one, Ellsworth will be in the 1-1. 21-point lead. Now they got a
technical foul. Player came on the court before she was beckoned.
I think he looked, and she went to report in. They'd already given the ball to the free thrower, and that was too late. She went in.
She still gets to shoot her one free throw.
Yes. Yeah.
But then Minneapolis will.
We'll shoot free throws of her own, and we'll get the ball. That throw is in there. Nice free throw there by Zavesky. She hit them both. Now Shoemaker comes back in for Cranston. And who do you think will shoot our free throws, Scott?
Shoemaker.
Well, we don't want to jinx her or anything. Free throw shooting champion down at Horton. And that front rim, back rim, and out. And I've done that numerous times. I know exactly what she's looking at there. Just a little bit of arch, and it goes in. And it does.
There, she supplants J.C. for 8th place. Minneapolis will have the ball at midcourt, at half court.
Shoemaker now the 8th leading scorer in Minneapolis school history. Passed her sister. One to shoot. Greg gets it off. It's good.
Yes!
Nice job, Kylie Greg.
It looked good all
That was a sweet shot by Kylie. 1.3 seconds catch and shoot.
She's done that twice at the buzzer. She did it about four or five games ago and hit one right at the buzzer, and that one was nothing but net. And I was just hoping she would get into the offensive swing a little bit, but You know, the presence of mind to let that one go with 1 second left, and buzzer went off, Ford got to the basket. It counted, and Minneapolis takes a comfortable 24-point lead. End of the fourth quarter, Minneapolis 42, Ellsworth 18.
Community. The Minneapolis Chamber of Commerce support of the Minneapolis High School Lions sports programming is just...
Welcome back to Minneapolis, Kansas. Lady Lions well in control, 42-18. Nice job by Kylie Gregg to catch and shoot that three at the end. Bearcats with the ball here to start the fourth quarter.
2-3 zone by Minneapolis. McCoy in the lane gets it back outside to Swati. She looks a little bit out of sorts. Maybe she's not the Swati I'm thinking of. McCoy in the baseline has it taken away by Shoemaker. Now the outlet pass to Page. Almost a palm there. No call. Out front to Macy. Right-hand wing, Gregg. Baseline, Shoemaker. Now out front. Entry pass to Crossing.
And going to be a foul on the Bearcats. Just the 16 foul.
I tell you, Ashlyn Macy's a gritty little competitor there. She just jumped right back in there. The ball bounced off Crossing, and she didn't hesitate. She went after that thing and got it back. Macy on the wing. Skip pass from Page to Gregg. Now Page, dribble drive out front to Macy. Shoemaker on the right. Back to Shoemaker, open three-point look.
Good. Nice job. Nice job by Kelsey Page to drive and dish. That was a great pass, and then a steal by Shea, and then a tie-up. Nice job by the ladies right there. But let's go back to just a second here. Kelsey Page did a great dribble penetration. While she's in the area, passes it backwards, back right to Shea Shoemaker, and she drains a three. And what a great shot.
Yeah, great job breaking down the defense. And lo and behold, the recipient of that gift, Shea Shoemaker, all alone at the three-point line. Now Gregg. That inside-out game is so important. It moves that defense around, gives you that open look, as Shoemaker was right there for the shot. Now Page looking inside, skip pass to Macy. Down the lane she goes, Crossing. Could be a three-second call, no call. Now Gregg comes from the top of the key to claim that rebound. Page with the drive in the lane, no good. It's tipped out there in Minneapolis. Just relentless on the offensive glass. Crossing.
Nice job by Kelsey Page to get it down low to Crossing. And J.C. will go to the line.
Yeah, Crossing turns and shoots. That's at least a one-and-one, if not a two-shot foul. She's shooting two. Merle with the reach-in foul. J.C. Crossing, two shots here for Lady Lions. Free throw rimming off. 45-18, 6:14 left. Fourth quarter action, J.C. Crossing. Shot's good. She hits one of two from the stripe. Cranston gets it off to Conley. Skip pass is knocked out of there by Crossing, and she's quick enough to go get it. Macy, jump shot, no good. Crossing with a nice clear out. Gregg with a shot off the glass, no good, and Crossing.
Great hustle by Lady Lions right there. As Kelsey Page in the lane, no good. I'll tell you, these girls are fighting hard. And J.C. Crossing. Wow, nice job by J.C. Crossing underneath, and she just starts to power down there. Nice
every
job.
Every loose ball, every rebound that comes in there, she either has a hand on it or she's got them tied up. She just is relentless on the offensive rebound backboard there. It's good to see. She gets after it. Long shot, Swati, no good. And Shoemaker with the big board for Minneapolis. Gregg out front, off to Macy. Entry pass to Crossing to Page. Three-point shot is rimming off. And McCoy collects that long carom for Ellsworth. Now Swati back to McCoy. Dribble drive, kicks it out to Landon. Shot no good, and Macy with the rebound finds Shoemaker down the court. Layup, good. Boy, she's got a nice scoop shot. She gets in around the glass. She can just She puts it up so nice and easy, away from the pressure. Now, that's going to be a backcourt.
And the tie-up. Great job, once again, Ashlyn Mason. Ashlyn is just all over the place, and these girls just don't know when to quit. Nice job by Ashlyn.
Now,
great
Merle
job.
Is having trouble at midcourt, and out come the starters as Deja Martin, Frazier, Kara Frazier, Anna Giles, and Steinbrock. So Ann Steinbrock's been in quite a bit this game. Now Martin out on top to Baker. Emma Giles with the ball on the baseline out front to Deja Martin. Nice ball movement here by the second group. Martin with a shot, partially blocked. Baker with the
great hustle by Baker. Kicks out to Frazier.
Deja now down to Emma Giles on the baseline. Gets rid of it to Frazier. Nice ball movement here. Baker off to Frazier, lets it rip. Rimming off. Now Savitsky for Ellsworth. A good defense by Frazier to shut off the penetration. Out front to McCoy. Dribble drive off to Conley. Conley's hit a three from there. And Landon back to Conley. That one's no good. Swatty kicks it back into McCoy. Rescues the ball for the Lady Bearcats. Out front, Landon, now off to Zaveski, back to Swatty. Shot no good. And it's saved by Conley back to Steinbrock. Minneapolis.
Nice save by Conley.
3 minutes left in this contest. Baker with the ball on the left-hand wing.
Should be a continuous clock, is that right, Dale?
Should be now. We're up at 40, yeah.
30, yeah. And it is as Steinbrock is hacked by, let's see who the foul is on. I think it was on Swatty.
So in just in case you're wondering, continuous, well, no.
It's called timeout.
Full timeout taken, and we'll take one too. Minneapolis having the way here with the Lady Bearcats. 48-18, 2:37 left in this contest. We'll be back after this quick timeout.
Trust is a word that is very important in this day and age, especially when it comes to insurance. Since 1982, you've trusted the Davidson Agency in Delphus and Minneapolis to give you the best home, auto, farm, crop, life, and health insurance. Call Lyle Davidson at the Davidson Agency, your trusted choice.
There's nothing more important than our children. That's exactly why the Lions Den was established in Minneapolis, so the kids could get together in a clean and healthy environment to have fun. It's a great place to party. The Lions Den, downtown Minneapolis.
Here we go, getting ready to start. Levi, what do you think of the, Levi, what do you think of the game now? Minneapolis up by 30. Think we're going to be able to pull this one out?
Yeah.
Pretty good job on that offensive glass down there. Crossing just taking it away and ripping it away, and she's getting a hand on about everything down there, isn't she?
Yeah.
Well, Steinbrock at the free throw line here. Minneapolis up 30. Off the front of the rim, no good. And Ellsworth with the ball for, well, I guess it's, they've got most of their reserves in too. That's Bettenbrock, I guess, with the ball. Savitsky underneath is fouled.
Frazier, I believe.
Good call there.
Kara Frazier with the reach-in foul. It's a 1-1, Minneapolis with their seventh team foul.
Zimmerman in for Steinbach.
Kenzie in, Zimmerman. She brings a lot of energy to the floor when she gets in there. Real pleased with her play the other night when she was in. And that's a 1-1 for Zaveski. She
didn't realize that she was, that's two shots. Yeah. That's 1-1. I made the first one, didn't I?
Down to a minute 50.
And she does. She's made three in a row from the free throw line. Make that. Yep, that one rimmed off. I knew I'd jinx her.
Should be a travel.
That's a travel. As Steinke comes out of there with that loose ball. And Minneapolis will play it in. Buck 30 left in this contest. Deja Martin with the ball in the backcourt. Gets it off to Frazier. Kara looking inside. Down the wing, Baker. The baseline. I thought she was going to get it to Zim. Now the swing pass to Frazier. Looking inside. Zimmerman's there. And now down to Giles on the baseline. Now the entry pass is tipped out of there by Shoemaker as Zimmerman was open for a second. Minute left in this contest. Baker to play it in for Big Blue. Into Zimmerman. And Swati will put Zimmerman on the free throw line here to shoot a 1-1. A little bit too much pressure on Zimmerman, and she goes to the free throw line. 1-1.
Clock's running at 35 seconds.
Free throw no good. And Shoemaker collects the rebound for Ellsworth. Bettenbrock off to Savinsky, back to Bettenbrock. Long shot, no good. And Frazier has that rebound from Minneapolis, but it will be Ellsworth's ball. Tipped off somebody's hand there. Kira had a hand on it for a minute. 12 to shoot here as Ellsworth plays it in. Shoemaker shot from the baseline, rimming off, and
nice rebound by Zimmerman there.
5 to shoot. Zimmerman off to Baker. Jump shot from the wing, no good.
Nice job of the Lady Lions tonight to come away with a 48-19 victory.
That's kind of a mark of an improved team. They didn't run up the score. They were just consistent all the way through. They put 48 on the board and hold Ellsworth to just 19 points.
Yeah, as they came away it felt like the third quarter they kind of started a little slow, but they finished strong in the third quarter, and then just a nice game for the Lady Lions tonight. Missed some easy shots, missed some close ones, but nice jump for the ladies.
Well, milestone for Shea Shoemaker as she passed her sister Jacy in the scoring record book as Shea Shoemaker slips into eighth place in the Minneapolis all-time scoring list. And I think she had 21 tonight, or right around that many, leading the Lions in scoring as we're getting ready for a little in-between game entertainment. And we'll be back with some stats and the halftime entertainment here in just a minute.
Eagle Community.
Welcome back to Minneapolis as the Lady Lions come away with a victory tonight, 48-19 over the Ellsworth Bearcats. And run through the scoring real quick for the Lady Lions. The Shea Shoemaker led the way, 22 points, as she breaks her sister's, goes into, what'd you say, Dale, eighth place or seventh?
Eighth place, by herself.
Eighth place by herself, and she have two more sisters to beat?
One more,
so.
See, there was two other sisters playing, but... I can't think of her oldest sister's name off the top of my head, I'm sorry. She was not in the top 10 in scoring.
So Shea leads away at 22, followed by Kelsey Page with 11. 6 by Ashlyn Macy, 5 by Kylie Gregg, 3 by Allie Steinbrock, and 1 by J.C. Crossan. As the Lady Lions come away with a nice victory tonight, 48-19 over the Ellsworth Bearcats. And Ellsworth Bearcats, led the way by 8 points by Madison Connolly, with 8, 5 by Alina Zavinsky, 2 by Brittany Bettenbrock, 2 by Whitney Steineke, and 2 by Heather McCoy. And turnover-wise, very unofficial on this. Ellsworth had 15 turnovers in the first half. They did a much better job in the second half. They only had 8 unofficial.
Yeah, they handled the press tonight much better than they did at home.
The first time they met us. Lady Lions, though, as they come away with the victory tonight over the Ellsworth Bearcats, 48-19, as Minneapolis improves 7-7, 4-3 in league, and nice job by the ladies tonight.
Yeah, all important victory for the ladies, 4-3 in the league. That's a big one there, and 500 overall. It's a big win for the Lady Lions as they look forward to another home game here coming up this Friday. But I thought they did a really good job on the defensive end, limiting Ellsworth just to 19 points. Just says a lot about their defense. They stayed in that 2-3 zone most of the game. I did see a little man-to-man here and there, but for the most part, 2-3 zone, and just kept Ellsworth at bay. Ellsworth not much from the outside. Conley hit a couple outside shots and a couple trays, but for the most part, no one else really an outside threat.
No. Felt like the ladies did a nice job tonight as they only 2 3-pointers. Kylie Gregg hit a three at the end of the third quarter, and Shea Shoemaker hit one at the beginning of the third quarter. Kind of cold from three-point range. I'm sorry, Shea had another three-pointer in there. She had two tonight. But not real good from the outside. That'd be the only thing that I would say to come away from this game looking at is that we weren't hitting a lot of our shots.
You know, when we're hitting our shots fairly decent, Minneapolis will score 55, 58, 60 points a ball game. And the score is indicative of the way they were shooting. It's just, as Scott mentioned, not a real sharp shooting evening. Not really too good shooting in close. And we had a few of the long ones, but could have been a lot worse here on the score.
I hope we get the coldness out of our system and get ready for next Friday against the Sacred Heart Knights.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And this is a good warm-up to get ready for Sacred Heart Knights come Friday night. So Lady Lions come away with a victory tonight by a score of 48-19. We are going to go ahead and send it. I'm assuming we'll have an interview with Coach Weatherman.
Well, I saw him walk out the door.
Well,
here he comes.
Here
he comes. All
okay,
right.
Hold on. Well, we will go ahead and keep him here. And I believe, I'm not sure if he's going to, looks like he's going up top. Hey, Dale, he's going that way. Dale, he's going that way. So we'll, I think we're going to have Coach Weatherman get on with us here. And I'm not sure what you just did there, what you just hit there.
Here we go.
A little bit better. Okay, Coach Weatherman, you with us up there?
Okay.
Coach Weatherman?
Yes, sir.
There you go. Coach, congratulations on a nice victory. As it's kind of crowded, you can't quite see us up here, but I'll tell you right now, Coach, a nice victory tonight, 48-19. Felt like the girls did a nice job of coming out and getting some transition points. Felt like they struggled a little bit from the field early on, but they the defense and the intensity still comes away with a nice victory.
Yeah, the first half, you know, we talked in before the game started, and two things we wanted to focus on tonight was, first of all, our intensity, and then second of all, our execution. I felt like our intensity was great from the word go. We struggled a little bit from the floor, like you said, but, you know, for I think it was about 2 minutes to go in the first quarter before they got their first basket. You know, we struggled with the execution aspect of things, but I think we were so keyed up to be playing at home for the first time in such a long time that that kind of took a little bit of our concentration away.
Coach, give us a comment on J.C. Crossan. She looked like she was all world a couple of different possessions down here. I got so tickled, but I was really impressed with her play tonight.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, she plays hard. You know, for being about 5'8", 100-pound post player, she gets in there and battles with the best of them. You know, she's going to put a body on somebody and get herself good position, you know. You know, hopefully within a year, you know, add, you know, maybe a couple inches, a little bit of weight on her. You know, she'll be a real force underneath there, hopefully, for us. She does an excellent job anticipating the ball on defense and does a good job rebounding as well.
Does that mean you're anticipating a 6-foot crossing?
I would sure hope so.
Coach, if you got a minute, could you elaborate a little bit on Kelsey Page's play tonight? I was just really impressed with her intensity tonight.
Yes, of course, she struggled last week, both games a little bit, and she kind of got herself on track in the third quarter against Russell last Friday night, and her and I sat down and had a long talk this morning, and I thought she that really paid off. She play with so much more intensity and a lot more confidence. You know, she had a couple situations where she got called for traveling. I didn't see her hanging her head or anything like that. She just kept playing ball. And, you know, like I told her, I said, you just keep playing ball, good things will happen. And I thought we saw that was a prime example of tonight with Kelsey. You know, she just kept playing hard, good things happen, and we saw a lot of positive.